don't bring a curling iron or anything, so this is called Out of the Shower, and here we go. Beautiful day in Steamboat. We're heading home, though, getting ready to catch the plane. But there's the snow and the ski and everything else. But we have about 20, 30 minutes before our car comes and gets us and takes us to the airport. And I have a word in my spirit for you. I woke up this morning, I was praying, studying, reading God's word, going through things, having my coffee, breakfast with my baby. And I just thought, and the Lord kept saying, restore, restore, restore. And I kept hearing that word, I will restore. So I started looking up in almost every version. And there are two things I want to talk to you about. First one's in Joel chapter 2, and the second one is in Galatians chapter 6. Now, whatever you've gone through, I believe that God restores everything the enemy stole from you sevenfold. And anything you've willingly given according to Scripture, any homes, any land, any houses, any relationship that you've given for the kingdom's sake, God will restore to you a hundredfold in this lifetime. To restore means back again, but it's not just back as back before whatever event you went through. Back again before the fall of mankind to the original intention that God had for you, for your family, for your life. So here's the word of the Lord. I believe we're in supernatural revival. Some really cool things happened to me. John and I got away for like 3 days, 4 days, came up skiing, and just wanted to have a good time of relaxing because it's been just crazy busy in a good way as always. Finishing up my book, working on things, have a lot of great things happening. Paula White Ministry, building a new studio, going on television in a massive way again. Seeing God just do incredible things, planting churches, believing God for the big. I just feel like it's a season that you go, okay, God, I'm stepping out of faith. I'm getting out of the boat. I'm walking on the water. And it's like the Lord saying, do it and see if I'll not back it. And I challenge you just to walk in faith right now that all things are possible with God. So I get this amazing phone call the first day that we land, and it just really solidified part of my purpose in the earth. Then I'm standing in line. Now, this might be small to somebody, but we're at the grocery store picking up groceries, and I have a Starbucks app, of course, and I'm standing in line, and the couple behind me said, don't know me, anything. My app's like taking a little bit longer. And they said, hey, let us get yours. And I had my cappuccino and John's, you know, triple espresso macchiato and my sugar cookie. And he said, no, no, no. I'm like, no, because it was so difficult for me to receive, easy for me to give. And that's something that I always work on. And he said, no, honestly, he said, let me do this. And he said, people do it for me all the time. And I said, well, I'll pay it forward. I said, thank you for blessing. I'll make sure that I bless someone else. And I do every day. I try to be a blessing to someone somehow, whether it's buying a coffee or praying over them or giving them a hug or whatever. And it might sound small, but it was so significant to me that just randomly a stranger buys my coffee. And I thought, man, God, you're so good. You bless me and John with coffee and a cookie. I mean, it might sound small to you. But it was just like another thing that God's going, girl, I've got you. You go for this. I'm going to restore to you everything that the enemy stole from you. All time, all finances, relationships, things that you thought, there's no way I can redeem. There's no way that you'll ever get back to this place or that'll happen. But the devil is a liar. God says your latter shall be greater than your former. And so here in Joel chapter 2, watch what he says. And this is a word for someone, because I went through years, not just like a day or a week, but years where the enemy was just like, pound, pound, pound. I'm going to get you. I'm going to destroy you. I'm going to silence your voice. But the devil is a liar. Whatever you're going through, know that sometimes your greatest, greatest breakthroughs are before your biggest battles. And Joel chapter 2, of course, let's start with verse 23 for time's sake. It says, be glad then, you children of Zion. Rejoice in the Lord, your God, for he had given you the former rain moderately, and he will cause to come down for you the rain, the former rain and the latter rain in the first month. Well, you know that's impossible in the natural. And God says, in the first month, I'm going to cause the latter and the former rain to come. Now, there's so much I could teach there, because what that means is God says, I'm going to cause the time of planting and the time of harvest to happen at the same time for you. This is going to be a supernatural miracle. And I, God, am the one that's going to do it for you. And he goes on verse 24, and the floor shall be full of wheat, and the fats shall overflow with wine and oil. Wheat, of course, we know represents manna, the word of God. And God says, I'm going to give you revelation. Revelation for your life, for your purpose, for your marriage, for your relationships, for your business, for your destiny, for everything. I'm going to fill you with revelation, the word of God. And then also, he said it will overflow with oil and with wine. We recognize that as the anointing, the Holy Spirit, that there's going to be an abundance coming to you. But here's where I wanted to get to. And it says, and I will restore to you the years. Now, this is where it's great. The years, watch, that the locust hath eaten and the cankerworm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army, which I sent among you. And you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God that have dealt wonderfully with you, and my people will never be ashamed. And I will restore to you the years. I'm speaking to someone who has gone through years, years of disappointment, years of cycles that the enemy seemed to have the upper hand, years of cycles of generational curses, of demonic interruption, years of sickness, years of depression, years of poverty, years of hopelessness, years of why is it not my turn, years of waiting, years. And God says, I am going to restore to you the years that the cankerworm, the palmer worm, the locust has eaten, and you will eat in plenty. I'm talking to you spiritually, emotionally, relationally, financially. God is not a man that he should lie. Isaiah 55:11 says his word will not return void. I don't know what the enemy came and stole years from you. It seems like, man, I should be so much further ahead. I should be married by now. I should have children by now. My business should be off the ground by now. My ministry should be soaring by now. God, I know you gave me these promises. You showed me the end from the beginning, but the enemy got in there in the middle of the process. And it seems like there was so much loss. Like, why did that happen? Why did he decide to leave me and trade me in when I was 40 for two 20s? Why did this happen? Why did the economy collapse? Why did I get laid off? Why did my business not make it and I had to file for bankruptcy? Stop asking the wrong questions. Because Romans chapter 8, verse 28 says that the enemy meant it for bad, but God will turn it for the good to those who love him and are the called. And you are called by God to the called according in harmony with his purpose, his intention. So I want to let you know that God is going to restore the years. I'm not talking about something you went through for a day or 2 days, but I'm talking the years that you've gone through. God is restoring it in the name of Jesus. I decree it, I declare it, and according to Job chapter 22, verse 28, get ready, for God is a supernatural God that is going to restore to you the years of crying. Weeping endures for night, but joy cometh with the morning. It is joy time for you. It is morning time for you. And God is a God of supernatural deliverance, supernatural restoration. And he can do it like this. He said, hey, we're in famine today. We're eating ass's head and dove's dung. But tomorrow by this time, I declare divine supernatural acceleration to you. The other thing that I wanted to share to you about restoration, and that's really the word that I had for you, the years are going to be restored. But Galatians chapter 6, verse 1, says this, and I thought it was really good about restoring. It says in the Message version, it says, live creatively, friends. If someone falls into sin, forgivingly restore him, saving your critical comments for yourself. You might be needing forgiveness before the day's out. Stoop down and reach out to those who are oppressed. Share their burdens and so complete Christ's law. And I really like that too, because it said, hey, you who live creatively, who walk in the Spirit of God, you who know, because God is, the first thing he shows himself is as a creator. He says, if someone falls into sin, misses the mark and falls short, instead of kicking him to the curb, instead of saying, you got what you deserved. Oh, well, it's not going to happen. He says, forgivingly restore him, saving your critical comments like, you deserve this. You brought this upon yourself. Save this critical comments because you might find yourself needing forgiveness. And so I just declare to you that not only is God going to restore to you the years, but why don't you activate it? Be a restorer for someone. Maybe you're believing God for a home. Give someone a night in your apartment. meaning like be a blessing to them. Maybe you're believing God to own a grocery store or buy someone a bag of groceries. See, what I'm saying is you might not have the full picture, but you have something that you can do for someone who is in a less fortunate condition than you are, and you can restore them. You can bring a word of kindness. You can buy somebody a cup of coffee and just let them know, hey, God's thinking about you and he cares about you. All right, guys, love you. Let's pray together. Reagan, it's a word you needed. Don't give up in the name of Jesus. I declare that you will not quit. Anybody who feels like quitting, anyone who says it's too late, it's over. The devil is a liar. I speak hope to you. I speak encouragement to you, inspiration to you, that God is a miracle working God. Tarkisha, you receive it in the name of Jesus. Forgive and restore. Yamuna and Denise, declare and decree it according to Job 22, verse 28. Seanette prayed for you and your children. We lift your children up. We pray for you that God will restore, that God will do a supernatural miracle in your household. In the name of Jesus, let every demonic spirit and demonic network that is gathered to bring destruction against your household, against your purpose, against your life, be scattered and overturned in the name which is above every name, the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I declare restoration to you, your family, your household, relationally, spiritually, emotionally, financially, in your ministry, with your reputation, in every single area. Be blessed. And remember, let's pray for everyone. Love you guys. Heading home, getting ready to catch that plane and preaching tomorrow. If you're in the Florida area, even if you're not, drive there. I'm doing Power Night tomorrow night with John. He's got a brand new band. Things are exciting. 6 p.m. Laying hands on people, believing God for the supernatural. So meet me at New Destiny Christian Center in Apopka, Florida. That's 505 East McCormick Road. Of course, you can always go to the website at www.paulawhite.org. You'd think after 30-something years, I'd know my website. So go there and get the information.